This is a flight test report on the United States Air Force intercontinental ballistic missile Atlas 10A. Atlas 10A, the fourth ICBM to be flight tested, arrived at the Air Force Missile Test Center, Cape Canaveral, 18 July 1957. Following a series of component and system tests in Assembly Building J, the missile was erected in the Launch Pad 12 service tower on 27 September. While testing of 10A continued at the launch complex, data obtained during the flights of Atlas 4A and 6A were being analyzed. These evaluations indicated that the cause of failure of the two previous flight missiles were heat and vibration, and provided the basis for structural modifications for Atlas 10A. These modifications included shortened fairing and engine nacelle length, repositioned heat shield, replacing of most of the aluminum plumbing with stainless steel tubing, stronger pod attachments to the missile, redirection of turbine exhaust gases by canting the turbine and lube oil exhaust, and modification of the autopilot system. 10A was removed from the launcher 5 October, and the necessary changes were accomplished as field modifications in Assembly Building J at Cape Canaveral. Following the re-erection of 10A on the launch pad 27 October, the decision was made to flight test the missile without vernier engines. The engines were removed 30 October, and complex testing of the missile continued. A successful composite test was performed 14 November, and a successful mock firing was achieved 15 November. The first two attempts to flight readiness fire Atlas 10A were unsuccessful. Following the second attempt, the missile was removed from the launcher for the replacement of damaged components. Repairs consisted primarily of replacing both thrust chambers and the fuel duct at the inlet of the B2 thrust chamber propellant pump. The repairs and minor modifications completed, 10A was again erected on Launch Pad 12 on 3 December. A 36-second duration FRF was accomplished 10 December. Damage which resulted from this firing required replacement of the B1 thrust chamber. The replacement of the chamber was made at the launcher. Following an unsuccessful attempt to flight test 10A on 16 December and the successful flight of Atlas 12A on 17 December, it was decided to reinstall the 10A vernier engine and broaden the missile's flight test objectives. Vernier engine installation and checkout were accomplished 2 January 1958, and a satisfactory flight readiness firing of 36 seconds duration was conducted 2 days later on 4 January. The primary flight test objectives of Atlas 10A were to determine overall performance characteristics of the following systems during flight environment: booster propulsion system, vernier propulsion system, autopilot and control system, airframe. Additional primary test objectives were to evaluate environmental data during flight for system design purposes, and to determine performance characteristics of the launching system. The 7 January flight test was scrubbed during countdown due to loss of essential telemetry and a fuel valve leak. Atlas 10A was then once more prepared for launch. Launch occurred 10 January 1958 at 1048 hours Eastern Standard Time. Vernier engine ignition took place approximately 1 second prior to booster engine ignition. After 11 seconds of booster engine operation, the missile rose from the launcher. Liftoff was clean and stable, with the launcher mechanism functioning satisfactorily. Booster and vernier engine operation was normal. The missile followed the planned flight program and remained in visual observation until both booster and vernier engine burnout occurred after 127 seconds of flight as programmed. Atlas 10A impacted in a prescribed area 542 nautical miles downrange, 2 miles over, and 10 miles south of the predetermined impact point. The success of the countdown of Atlas 10A was especially noteworthy. Only one hold of 17 minutes was called during the entire countdown. This delay was necessary to reset a regulator in the ground pressurization unit. At launch, Atlas 10A had a gross weight of 182,750 pounds, with the booster and vernier engines developing 275,100 pounds of thrust. Booster and vernier engine performance levels were satisfactory throughout both the pre-launch and flight phases. The two vernier engines added improved guidance control. At burnout, Atlas 10A had attained 312,200 pounds of thrust and achieved a speed of 9,300 feet per second, or approximately 6,340 miles per hour. The success of the ICBM Atlas 10A flight reaffirmed that the modifications performed on missiles 10A and 12A ameliorated the factors that had contributed to thrust decay in the first two flight test missiles. The flight control system for 10A satisfactorily performed its function of maintaining prescribed missile attitude and airframe stability, and in controlling the programmed pitch over into the proper ballistic trajectory. As with Atlas 12A, all primary and secondary flight test objectives were again achieved, and subsystem compatibility of Atlas Series A missiles during flight environment was once more conclusively demonstrated. The flight of ICBM Atlas 10A was an unqualified success.